Oxon of Batangas City, 0917-838-4098. Itong kanyang text noon, DOST gives scholarships to deserving incoming first-year students. Why not let the students take courses leading to the development of all natural resources of power from air, sun, water, sea, and underground resources? So much is wasted. Alam po ninyo, that's an, to me, that's an excellent suggestion. And so you, we will be sending you a pasalod of 100 pesos. All right, and the second winner natin is si Jamju Rivera of Isabela City in Basilan, 0915-655-8385. Ito sabi niya, you have articulated the state sentiments of Mindanaoans opposing these endless peace talks. If all agreements are merely tactical, then isn't it just right to put this 40-year peace process to an end? Even plebiscites are tactical, not conducted to ask us whether we are in favor of one thing or not, but periodically hoisted upon us until we change our minds. In the meantime, our communities are terrorized until such time that a demographic shift produces the results they want from these plebiscites. Okay. Well, a little bit cynical, but I think you're touching on some very, very critical issues that confront us in dealing with the issues in Mindanao. Okay, so we've got a number of other texts that are now coming in, so we'll begin reading them and telling you about it. And I just want to remind you that we will be choosing several, one or two texters every program sa ating text promo. Okay, you can join our discussion by texting us, and the numbers are there on your screen. And make sure you include your name and location. And we will be sending you a pasalod. Okay? All right, from 0917-605-5739. Kung nakaalis sina Arroyo, hindi sila maa-arraigned. Hindi uusad ang kaso. Yung mga abogado, madali lang magsabi, hindi na sila abogado ng accused. Hindi na sila accountable. Okay, that's true, but we will get a resolution of this because the Supreme Court will be dealing with this issue with Secretary De Lima of the Department of Justice. Although the issue in itself has become somewhat moot and academic because a case has already been filed against President Arroyo and a warrant of arrest issued, and apparently she's now under hospital arrest. From 0908-873-7369 or 878-7369, i-house arrest na lang si GMA sa Tanay kung saan dinala si ERAP. Hindi ho pwede yun kasi bahay ni ERAP yun eh. Hindi naman bahay ni GMA yun. Unless aanyayahan siya ni ERAP na tumira dun sa bahay niya sa Tanay. Well, tingnan natin. Total, malaking utang na loob niya kay GMA sapagkat siya ang nag-pardon kay ERAP, di ba? Kanya siya nakatakbo uli eh. Maski na conditional yung pardon, di ko nga rin maintindihan kung paano nangyari yun. From 0908-878-7369. Ngayon, ang final battle between Gloria appointees in the Supreme Court and DOJ Secretary De Lima. Well, alam mo, ako'y nalulungkot kung yan ay tinitingnan ng marami as final battle because it should not be. You know, it does not matter to me kung sino nag-appoint sa isang tao sa Supreme Court. I would like to think na kung sino man ang na-appoint sa Korte Suprema, minsan silang na-appoint, sila'y sumumpa. Hindi na sila tao, ng sino mang nag-appoint. They are no longer beholden, they are not beholden to the powers that appointed them. Hindi pwede sabihin na, hindi, ito justice ko ito, ako nag-appoint dyan. Malaking kalokohan yun. Walang utang na loob ang sino mang justice sa Korte Suprema na na-appoint sa Korte Suprema, wala silang utang na loob sa Pangulo na nag-a-appoint sa kanila. Their first and primary obligation is to the law and to make independent and fair judgments according to their understanding of the law. Not kumiling dito at doon. Yan, dito kaya kuminsan napoproblema tayo kasi napakadami nagsasabing kayang abutin ng Korte Suprema dito at doon. Pero kanya kumisan, tinatabangan ng tao tungkol sa ating paraan ng hustisya. Pero I would like to think that our justices have a capacity to rise above petty political considerations and understand that they are not beholden to the appointing power when they get to the Supreme Court. Maybe I'm in favor of a change in the way the Judicial Bar Council vets the people who are appointed to judiciary. Kasi bago po maaliya, kailangan susulat ka pa dun sa Judicial Bar Council. Sabi mo, interesado ako sa pwestong ito. Why don't they simply consider the people? And then, minsan nakapili na kayo nun sa lima, doon, tsaka nyo kausapin at tanungin kung, oy, if you are appointed, will you accept? But yung dahil sa, you want the people to apply themselves for the position, tingin ko parang pangit. But that's the way the Judicial Bar Council operates. They solicit people to write in if they're interested in certain positions in the judiciary. From 0921-780-1231, bakit pinakikialaman ng gobyerno ang Mindanao? Dapat paalisin ang mga sundalo. Well, I don't know who that came from, but you know, the soldiers are also necessary to help protect other parts of society that are non-Muslim. Now, but of course, they are there to protect both Muslim and non-Muslim. Pero alam natin na within the Muslim communities, katakot-takot din ang bangayan at kidnapping na ginagawa nila isa kontra sa isa. And but that unfortunately has been a way of life in that part of our nation, you know, long before the Spaniards got here. So maybe you should also view the presence of members of the armed forces as a mediating force there that can protect the majority of the population. Kanya lang, it is our hope also that the members of the armed forces will behave much better and will be more circumspect in their actions and in what they do. From 0917-605-5739, dapat makonvict at makulong si Arroyo sa mga kasalanan niya pero bigyan siya ng clemency ni Pinoy after 5 years, katulad kay Erap. Oh, hindi naman 5 years si Erap, ilang buwan lang sa loob yan, binigyan na ng pardon eh. So, hindi, but if you're recommending 5 years para siya mabigyan ng pardon, and then, kung si minsan po nakikita natin itong problema, kung yung ordinaryong citizen, pagka naatangan ng sentensya, is only subject for parole, the conviction of a former president for very, very senior, very serious crimes, why should they be pardoned? You know, if we are trying to set an example to the people that everybody is equal before the law, and not people are, some people are more equal before the law, huwag natin i-convict isang tao para sabihin sa kanya, hindi papadong kita after 5 years. To me, that doesn't make much sense. And I would rather just let the law take its course. And depending upon the circumstances, although there is no limitation on the power of the president to grant clemency, but it needs to be applied for. Hindi po pwedeng basta magpapardon ng presidente. You have to apply for clemency. That's the way it works. Okay? All right. So, dito po natin nakikita na marami pang ibang pumapasok. Ito naman from 0947-234-1628 from Dr. Primo Castillon. Graft and corruption, politics is the root cause of poverty of the people. Wow. Okay. From 0917-900-3211. The scene at the NAIA when GMA tried to leave for medical treatment is obviously orchestrated. If the husband is really concerned about her condition, why taking the gate as an entry knowing there will be a lot of people? Why did they not use what Horn requested from airport officials for clear passage? The Arroyo camp themselves put her at risk to get Filipinos' sympathy. What kind of husband allowing his sick wife to go through something like that? Well, hindi ko po alam if that was a drama na set there to create sympathy.